Vince, how long did you actually live in Guatemala?
Oh, he was gone for ages.
I was in the jungle, the bush we called it, for approximately 9 months.
9 months? My God, that really must have been something.
Sheldon, it was unbelievable. I saw things. They have tsetse flies down there the size of eagles.
Really? In the evening, I would stand in front of my hut and watch in horror
as these giant flies would pick children off the ground and carry them away.
My God.
All the things he told us.
Oh, it was an incredible sight.
Peasants screaming, chasing these flies down the road, waving brooms. You can imagine the pathetic quality of this, waving these crudely fashioned brooms at these enormous flies as they carry their children off to almost certain death.
Oh, that is just the most horrible thing.
You sure these are flies you're talking about?
Flies. Natives had a name for them. Jose Grecos de Muertos.
Oh.
Flamenco dancers of death.
You took those slides of them that never came out, remember?
Well, that's a shame. I really would have liked to have seen those slides.
Me too.
Yeah, I left them in a jacket that got modernized. I tell you, it broke my heart because those slides would have won me a Pulitzer Prize. The enormous flies flapping slowly away into the sunset. Small brown babies clutched in their beaks.
Wow.
Beaks. Flies with beaks.
Sight I'll never forget. I was stunned, appalled.
What did you do?
What did I do?
As a consultant, what did you do about the flies?
Sadly, there's very little you can do because of the tremendous red tape in the bush.
There's red tape in the bush?
Enormous red tape, gentlemen. These flies, for example, they're protected against pilferage under the provisions of the Guacamole Act of 1917.